Yes, sir, now you are audible.
Look at this reaction. So in this, copper oxidation state is a plus one.
Okay, it was my fault.
Not audible.
Sir, your video is not visible.
Video is not visible.
Sir, it's visible.
Yes, sir, not.
Okay, I think so. Audio video is clear, I think. Now listen. In this reaction, cuprous oxide oxidation state, so copper oxidation state is a plus one and changing it to zero. So it is going from the deficit to zero. Increasing or decreasing the oxidation number? So it says gain of electrons. It says reduction. So cuprous ions are getting reduction. And again, you see the sulfur. Sulfur minus 2 and here plus 4. How much change? Sulfur minus 2 to plus 4. Loss or gain? Batao. Is it loss or gain? Minus 1, minus 2 to plus 4.
Loss of
electrons. So this is loss of electrons, no? Loss of electrons, is it oxidation or reduction?
Oxidation.
So the sulfur getting oxidized, sulfur getting oxidation, cuprous ions getting reduction. So now you must balance this reaction. You must balance this reaction. How to balance? So find out the electron difference. Sulfur losing how many electrons? Tell me. Sulfur losing how many electrons? Minus 2 to plus 4. How much? How many electrons?
Six.
So six electrons. Six electrons. The sulfur is losing. If the sulfur is losing 6 electrons, who is benefiting? Who is getting that 6 electrons? Cuprous ions are getting these 6 electrons and changing to copper. So then 6 electrons. And here the electron change, cuprous ion, how many it is gaining? Plus 1 to 0. How many electrons difference?
1.
1 electron difference. So then 1 into 6, you can equate the electrons, 1 into 6. That means here, what I'll do means, here I'll take the 6. And so here it will be how much? Can I write 2? Can I write 2 here? 2 into 2, 4, here 2, 6 cupric, copper atoms. Because cuprous ions are 2 places, all in 2 here, and here oxygen atoms are 2, and if I mention 2 here means oxygen is 2. So tell me, is that equation is balanced? Check it now. Is that equation is balanced? Yes, nobody is talking. And from this reaction, tell me which substance is said to be oxidant, which substance is reductant. So which is oxidant which is reductant. Reductant. I mean to say, which is oxidizing agent and which is reducing agent. Reducing agent. Who will tell? Yes, I understand what I'm talking about.
The reductant itself.
Reducing agent. Oxidizing agent is.
लिखो खाता संख्या.
Oxidizing agent is. See. Oxidizing means which get reduction?
Yes.
Yes, sir. An oxidizer rather.
So oxidant means oxidizing agent means which get reduction? Which is getting reduction here?
Copper.
Copper. And reducing agent. Reducing agent. Which get oxidation?
It's cuprous sulfide.
Reducing agent is here the so sulfide is getting oxidation, that means cuprous sulfide, and here the cuprous oxide is getting, so what we call means here is plus, this is getting this is getting reduction, this is oxidant, this is getting oxidation, this is reducing agent, right? Yes.
Sir, but when we would be writing the name of the oxidant and reductant, we would be writing the whole compound.
See, in terms of electrons you are writing, you can go specifically. And okay, if you write like that, cupric sulfide, if you write, means in this cupric sulfide, which is getting oxidation? Sulfur only, no? See.
Yes, sir.
So,
see, video is paused.
Problem. There is a power cut problem here. Okay, so yesterday we were talking about, so we were discussing types of reactions. Types of reactions. Types of reactions based on redox, based on redox means reduction and oxidation. So we completed metal displacement, and some more examples are discussed. Metal displacement, the metal displacement reactions, I told three types: metal versus metal, non-metal versus non-metal, metal versus non-metal. The third category is metal versus non-metal displacement. Displacement. So metal versus non-metal displacement. So here is the first one. So I was talking about metal versus non-metal displacement. When metal react with water, when metal react with acid, this comes under, so metal versus non-metal displacement, when metal react with the water, when the metal react with the acid. So these we can take example for metal versus non-metal displacement. So these reactions follows redox category. Redox reactions we say. So now you look at the sodium when combined with water, when the sodium metal is dropped in the water, the cold water. So what happened? You can guess. Tell me. This is the most familiar reaction. When the sodium metal is dropped in the water, you'll get sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen gas comes out. The sodium is displacing the hydrogen. The sodium is displacing the hydrogen from this, so water and H2 is coming out. Similarly, if you take calcium plus water, the calcium plus water, and you will get calcium hydroxide plus hydrogen gas comes out. And if you take magnesium if you take plus water gives rise to magnesium hydroxide plus H2 gas is coming out. So and so these are the reactions that follow redox. So how these reactions are said to be redox? Assign the oxidation states, then balance these reactions. Now tell me the first case, sodium oxidation state how much here? What is oxidation state of the zero? And in the hydrogen plus one, oxygen is minus two, the sodium is here plus one, and oxygen is here how much means minus two, hydrogen is plus one, and hydrogen is zero. And identify the element, so whose oxidation state is remain same, even the reactant and the product, that is hydrogen. But hydrogen has, see hydrogen is a zero and here is hydrogen is plus one. That means, so hydrogen oxidation state is not remain same.
Sir, oxygen.
So, now oxygen is remain same, excellent. Oxygen is remain same. So minus two and minus two. But what is changing? Sodium zero to how much plus one? Zero to plus one. Is it losing or gaining? Zero to plus one means so loss. So losing oxidation. This is oxidation. And hydrogen plus one to zero. Plus one to zero means reduction.
Gaining.
So gaining, reduction we say. So now the metal versus this water is said to be what we say, redox reaction we say, but this metal is displacing the hydrogen. So this is the hydrogen gas is coming out. In the form of gas, hydrogen is a non-metal. Hence this is metal versus non-metal we say. Now we can balance the reaction. So how to balance the reaction here? And this hydrogen, changing from plus one to zero, how many electrons difference?
Minus one.
One electron difference. But here hydrogen atoms are two. Two into plus one, plus two. And here is how much? So, two hydrogen atoms. Okay, hydrogen atoms are here two. Balanced hydrogen atoms are, but here is hydrogen atom is placed at one. So that means here hydrogen atoms are, so how many means 3, here is 2, that's why I am equating. So 4 I am making, here I am making 2, then hydrogen atoms are balanced. But sodium atoms, how many here? 2, and here I will make 2. So this is that reaction. Similarly, calcium when react with water, you will get calcium hydroxide. Magnesium plus water gives us to magnesium hydroxide. But if I write iron plus water, then what will be the compound?
Iron oxide.
Yes, Shambhavi, batao.
Then in the first reaction, Na plus H2O, where the hydrogen's oxidation state is same, would we ignore that in each case when it comes? H plus 1 both the cells.
No, I didn't get you. Means hydrogen plus 1 to 0 changing, no?
And so what about that OH1?
The OH1, see, the hydrogen is here. So one hydrogen is remain same. Okay. So here is, so two hydrogens oxidation state is the same, but other hydrogen atom is getting what? Reduction, no? So two hydrogen act as a spectator atoms, and the rest of the two are getting the reduction, no?
Yes, sir.
That's it. Now, if the iron react with the water, so what will be the compound you'll get? So Fe2O3 plus hydrogen gas. So in this case, when iron react with the water, you are getting this hydrogen gas and oxide, you are not getting the base. Because here iron is reacting with this water, steam. So whereas that means it is the gas. So where the magnesium, where this calcium, where this sodium are react with the liquid water, so the leftover water will make their oxides to dissolve and forming these bases. Since they are reacting with the liquid waters, so giving the base. But here is a steam oxide. Is the gas is formed, the metal is reacting. Similarly, iron, but if you take gold, if you take platinum, if you take the copper, they do not react with the water, even with the steam also, right? So now, that's why gold and silver and platinum are said to be what metals? Noble metals, we say. The last example I want to take, zinc plus HCl or H2SO4. So what happened? Tell me. Zinc sulfate AQ plus hydrogen gas comes out. So now you see zinc oxidation state 0, here is plus 2. Difference how many electrons? 2 electrons. Hydrogen changing from how much? Plus 1 into 2 and how much? 0. So how much difference? Electron difference 2 electrons. So is that equation balanced? The sulfate oxidation state remains same. Minus 2. This is -2. Here is -2. So the metal is displacing the hydrogen. Hydrogen is the non-metal. So hydrogen is a displacer. Right? So this is metal, non-metal, metal versus non-metal displacement chemical reaction which follow redox, reduction and oxidation. So now third type of reactions completed. The fourth type of reactions we will take. So what are those? So the fourth type reactions are this proportionate reactions. Disproportionate reactions. This is the fourth type of reactions. Right? So, what are the disproportionate reactions? These are special type of reactions, chemical reactions, I want to say. Special type of reactions, we say. So, why these are called special type of reactions? The disproportionate reactions are very important. Sometimes you will get questions surely on this disproportionate reactions in the competitive examination. One question you will get from the disproportionate reactions. So what are the disproportionate reactions? Means the reactions in which atom of an element in the compound, atom of an element undergoes oxidation as well as reduction simultaneously so in the reaction. That means the atom of the element so present in the compound undergoes oxidation as well as reduction simultaneously. That means in the same reaction, so atom of the element will undergo both oxidation and reduction. So that is said to be disproportionate reaction. As a result of this, so that compound will produce and two different compounds in the products. Two different products it can give. So example will discuss. Example for this. Two, three examples I'll give. So decomposition of hydrogen peroxide. This is one reaction. So how the hydrogen peroxide is decomposed, I want to say. Hydrogen peroxide formula is H2O2. So when the hydrogen peroxide kept in the sunlight in open conditions, if you just put this hydrogen peroxide liquid, this hydrogen peroxide liquid is kept in the open conditions, in the presence of sunlight, what happened? So after a few days, you observe in the container water and oxygen gas will escape. This is the reaction that takes place. The hydrogen peroxide is kept in the open conditions in the presence of sunlight. That means in the presence of sunlight, the hydrogen peroxide will change into the water. The hydrogen peroxide will change into the oxygen. So this reaction comes under disproportionate reaction. Disproportionate chemical reaction, we say. So how come this reaction is a disproportionate reaction? Check it now. So and tell me the oxidation state of the oxygen, oxidation number of this oxygen, the peroxide, how much I told in the rules. While talking in the rules, the oxygen -1 here, hydrogen is +1. Okay, and in the water it is +1 hydrogen. Oxygen is -2 and in this oxygen elemental form 0. Now increasing, decreasing oxidation number pata karo. Increasing, decreasing. The hydrogen changing from how much means? So hydrogen is remain same. +1 here, +1 here. So hydrogen is a spectator atom. Right? Hydrogen is spectator atom in the both case. This oxidation reduction is remain same, no? Oxidation is remain same or whatever it may be. And now oxygen, here how many oxygen atoms are there? Two oxygen atoms are there. So out of this two oxygen atom, one is getting reduction, am I right? One is getting reduction, no? So -1, -2, getting reduction. And other oxygen atom is, what is happening? -1 to 0 means oxidation. minus 1 to 0. Minus 1 to 0 means oxidation. Negative charge decreases means oxidation. That means, so in this reaction, tell me which is the element, atom of the element undergoing disproportionate reaction means oxygen, we say. Because oxygen is at the same time getting reduction and getting oxidation at the same time. So that's why this reaction is said to be disproportionate reaction, we say. This reaction is what we call disproportionate reaction. So we'll move into other examples. So what are the other examples for this disproportionate reaction?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
So in peroxide H2O2, peroxygen has minus one charge, no? Oxidation state. Then sir, O2 must have minus two, means two atoms.
See, hydrogen peroxide ka structure this one. So this will break up, right? Homolytically. So isko negative minus one milega, isko negative minus one milega, right? So now this is plus one, this is the plus one, okay? This is the plus one. And this oxygen atom is changing into what? H2O, am I right? And this oxygen atom is changing into what? Into O2. You can balance the reaction. Are you getting what I'm talking about? There are two oxygen atoms are present. These two oxygen atom bonds are, this peroxide linkage is breaking during the decomposition. This peroxide linkage is breaking. The one oxygen atom is changing into water. One oxygen atom is changing into O2. Clear?
So, but there are two oxygen and here these are three.
Yeah, you can balance with the number, no? Based on finding the electron difference, you can balance the electrons. So, you can balance the atoms also. Okay, I'll write the balanced equation also. H2O2 gives rise to H2O plus O2. Right? Now, oxygen atoms here, how many? Two. Here is only one. So, make it equal. So, 4, then if I write 2, is it balanced now?
Yes, sir.
Balanced?
Yes.
So, another example I want to give for this disproportionate reaction. Disproportionate reaction, another example I want to give. What is a disproportionate reaction is that. So, when chlorine gas is passed into, what is the solution? Strong alkali solution, aqua solution. So, this, when the chlorine gas is passed into the cold alkali solution. When the chlorine gas is passed into NaOH, so into cold solution, aqueous solution of NaOH, concentrated. So what happens means you will get NaCl, you will get NaOCl. You know NaOCl nowadays, we use more NaOCl. It is called sodium hypochlorite, disinfectant, and so disinfectant chemical for cleaning purpose we use, and will kill the microorganisms. Sodium hypochlorite, chloride, I am using the word. So NaOCl, NaCl. So here the chlorine is the atom, the element undergo oxidation and reduction simultaneously in this reaction. So this reaction is also said to be disproportionate reaction, we say. Check it now. So how the chlorine undergoes oxidation, reduction? The chlorine is elemental form, oxidation state is zero. And in this NaCl, chlorine oxidation state is minus one. And in this NaOCl, the chlorine oxidation state is a plus one because sodium hypochlorite. So the sodium is a plus one, oxygen is how much means minus two, and the chlorine will be the plus one oxidation state. So here the chlorine is changing into minus one, and the chlorine is changing into how much means plus one. That That means the chlorine in HOCl, HOCl hypochlorized, the chlorine oxidation state is a plus 1. So that means hypochlorous acid, chlorate and perchlorate, in that the chlorine oxidation state will be plus 1, plus 3, plus 5, plus 7. So here the chlorine is changing from 0 to minus 1, 0 to plus 1. So then tell me, here the chlorine is 0 to minus 1 means gain or loss. So gaining of electrons, how many? One electron.
One.
It's reduction. And the same chlorine is losing electron here. So oxidation. So when the chlorine passes into the NaOH solution, then so you can equate the reaction here to NaOH. So is that equation is balanced? 2 chlorine atoms. Not balanced, no. There is, if I take 2 and 2 Cl, 2 NaOCl, so where is that number is coming? One more. So water will come. That is the problem. Yes, now the reaction is correct. One more product is missing. When Cl2 passes into this NaOH, so NaOH, this is aqueous, I told you, aqueous. When the Cl2 passes into the aqueous solution, NaCl banega, NaOCl banega, then H2O. Because hydrogen is also there, no, here. So now we can balance this reaction. So now it is it balanced? Check it now.
Yes, sir.
Balanced. So what kind of reaction this is? Disproportionate reaction. Because in this disproportionate reaction, chlorine, the chlorine is getting oxidation as well as reduction simultaneously. So hence it, this is disproportionate reaction. And so in organic chemistry also we see disproportionate reaction, that is Cannizzaro reaction. They say Cannizzaro reaction, the famous reaction. In 12th class we will be learning. And last one, the same, when chlorine gas is passed into alkali solution, concentrated alkali solution, this is hard solution. Earlier we took the cold solution, so aqueous solution. And here the same, what the product will be? NaCl plus NaClO3 sodium chlorate banega plus H2O aega. The chlorine gas, when the chlorine gas passing into where? Into the hot alkali solution, aqua solution, this is aqua solution here. So we will get NaCl, we will get sodium chlorate. This is sodium chlorate. Earlier one is sodium chloride, hypochlorite. This is sodium chlorate and H2O. So in this also same, the chlorine changing the oxidation state 0, and in this minus 1, in this how much you can write? So assign the oxidation state of the chlorine here. So sodium is plus 1, plus chlorine is X, minus 2 into 3 equal to 0. How much? X value? Plus 5 or plus 3? Plus 5, sahi. So the chlorine oxidation state changing from how much? 0 to minus 1. This is reduction, no? And so 0 to plus 5 changing, how much means oxidation? It is, so oxidation, this is chlorine getting oxidation. the chlorine getting the reduction. Both is happening in this case. So based on the oxidation number difference, oxidation increasing, decreasing number difference, so balance this reaction. So balance this reaction, here the electron difference how much? So 5 electrons, here is minus 1, 5 electron difference is coming. So balance that equation, right? So this is the disproportionate reaction example we say. So now the types of reactions completed. Types of reactions. I think this decomposition, thermal decomposition also there, no? Thermal decomposition also there. So that also we'll discuss thermal decomposition. So give me example for this thermal decomposition chemical reaction. Is it a redox reaction or not? We'll check it now. Give me one example.
Ferrous sulfate.
This is comes under thermal decomposition. The ferrous sulfate solid. Fe2O3 plus SO2 gas plus SO3 gas. In case what is there means what also comes out.
So okay. That will be CO2, no? First reaction.
CO2 and SO3 also, no?
So first one, calcium carbonate.
Calcium carbonate, CO2, sorry. So CO2. So then ascend the oxidation states. This is plus 2, here is a plus 2, calcium is a spectator, oxygen is here minus 2, here is minus 2, here is how much minus 2, only the carbon oxidation state, carbon oxidation state, Patakaro, is it the same or different? Carbonate, CaCO3, so carbon oxidation state Patakaro plus 1, plus 2, plus x plus minus 2 into 3 equal to 0. What is the x value?
Plus 4.
Plus 4 aega. CO2 may plus 4 also, no? CO2 also plus 4. So, and so here there is no oxidation and there is no reduction, no? Yes? Do you find any oxidation reduction is happening in this thermal decomposition?
No, sir.
So no oxidation. And in this, so ferrous sulfate, this may plus 2, iron ka plus 3. So sulfur is plus 6 here, and here is plus 4, plus 6. So this is the decomposition, this is undergoing redox. This is the redox, clear? Because plus 2 to plus 3. Change is there, plus 6 to plus 4, change is there. This is said to be redox.
Sir, iron will be oxidized.
Iron is oxidized, sulfur is getting reduction. But okay. And I'll take the photochemical reaction. Photochemical reaction is what? AGBR. AGBR is kept in the sunlight, changing into AG, changing into BR, BR2, right? So, assign the oxidation numbers. Silver, plus 1. Bromine, minus 1. Silver is changing into 0. Bromine is changing into how much? 0, no?
Yes.
So plus 1 to 0, plus 1 to 0, minus 1 to 0. So which is getting oxidation, which is getting reduction? Bromine is
getting silver is silver is reduced.
So bromine is getting oxidation now?
Oxidized.
Oxidized. Silver is
reducing.
Reducing. Getting reduction. So now tell me the photochemical reaction. Photochemical reaction is redox reaction or not? So definitely redox reaction, photochemical reactions. Photochemical reaction is, so redox reaction we say. So
excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So in disproportionate reactions, how do we determine the reducing agent and oxidizing agent?
So reducing agent, because one element has a dual property, no? One element has a dual property. So one element has the dual property means which gets oxidation, which get reduction. The same principle. So we have to mention the same element is behaving like oxidizing agent and reducing agent.
Okay,
got it. And now double displacement reactions are there. Double displacement. So double displacement reactions. Double displacement reactions. Now tell me, these double displacement reactions are redox reactions or not? Are these double displacement reactions are redox reactions or not? You have to check. So take example. Any NO3 AQ solution, okay, and I'm taking NaCl plus AgNO3 is a aqua solution. Both solutions are mixed in the test tube. Kya hoga?
Sodium nitrate.
सोडियम नाइट्रेट बनेगा, NaNO3 आएगा आपको, NaNO3 AQ बनेगा, प्लस व्हाट सॉल्यूशन यू विल बी गेटिंग, AgCl प्रेसिपिटेट आएगा, प्रेसिपिटेट आएगा. सो अभी नाउ यू कैन असाइन द ऑक्सीडेशन नंबर्स टू दिस एलिमेंट्स. द सोडियम इज +1, सिल्वर इज -1, द सिल्वर इज +1, नाइट्रेट इज -1, द सोडियम इज +1, नाइट्रेट इज -1, silver is +1 and chlorine is -1. So do you find any increasing decreasing of oxidation number, so between the products and reactants? The sodium check karo, sodium is remain same, sodium oxidation state, sodium on both cases in reactant product in the same, remain same. Similarly fluoride and chloride remain same, silver and remain same, nitrate and nitrate remain same. Now tell me, is this double displacement reaction is redox reaction or not?
Yes.
No, sir.
No, it is. That means this is not considered redox reaction. Sometimes you will get the question in exam. So double means you will give the one chemical reaction and they will ask you, so identify the following reaction is not redox reaction. It will give displacement reaction, it will give photochemical reaction, it will give example. So one example is metal displacement, other one is combination, like that it will give you. So you have to pick out this double displacement reaction, not follows the redox reaction. Okay, so the types of reactions over with this. And the next class, we will talk about balancing chemical reaction by using two methods. One is oxidation number method, other one is half reaction method. But in our syllabus, half reaction method is not there. Only oxidation number method is there. So that we'll discuss in the next period. So read the lesson. So prepare. So rest of the chapters also for the exam. Right?